The Philippine Tax Bureau vows to study the estate tax case of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s family. BIR Commissioner Romeo Lumaki Jr. says they will look into the matter. During the campaign season, the estate tax case became a hot-button issue hurled against Marcos.
Pag-aaralan po natin yan at sisiguraduhin natin na lahat ng aksyon na nagagawin natin dyan ay yung naayon lang sa batas. Yun lang po yung gagawin natin.
Back in 1997, the Supreme Court ruled the Marcos family owed some 23 billion pesos in estate tax. But that amount swelled to 203 billion pesos due to non-payment and interest. The High Court order became final and executory in 1999.
At least one senator has called into question the verification process of the Philippines' new SIM registration law. But telcos and regulators say there's nothing to worry about. Jackie Pascual reports.
Telecommunication companies are gearing up for the first day of SIM registration on December 27. Senator Grace Poe, though supportive of the measure, has expressed concern over what she describes as a vague verification process under the implementing rules and regulations. She stresses the importance of verification because it serves as the first line of defense against misuse or cybercrime. This sentiment was echoed by a cybersecurity analyst.
Yun ang isa sa mga weakness na nakita ko dito sa SIM registration. Kasi hindi forte, hindi equipped at hindi well-trained ang mga telco para tignan kung fake o tunay.
But telcos have said they will base their systems on those already used overseas to ensure the security of stored data. At least one telco says it has already trained its staff on every step of the process, including verifying correct information.
From December 27 till January 11, we're going through a pilot phase. But as we become more mature dito sa registration process, magiging mas we will also include other processes such as facial recognition para maging mas accurate at mas foolproof, no, yung verification process natin.
Some mobile phone users also urge telcos to keep their personal information safe.
Dapat mas maganda lang yung gagawin nilang database para sa secured ba, para maiwasan yung mga leakage ng information.
Secured din yung details mo sa kanila. Yes. Like, sila lang yung magpa-process, sila lang yung maghahawak ng details mo, hindi maliling sa iba.
The National Telecommunications Commission tells mobile phone users not to worry as data privacy is a mandate under the law. If a leak does happen, telcos will be liable.
Yung breach of confidentiality po o leak ng mga information na yan, ay may parusa po na aabot po ng 4 milyon, no?
Yun.
Sa mga telcos na mapatunayan na sila ang naglabas ng information na hindi dapat ilabas.
Aside from telcos, subscribers who falsify their information may also face sanctions, another safety net. The NTC urges prepaid and postpaid users to register all their SIM cards as soon as the registration period opens to prevent deactivation. Telcos will announce more details in the coming weeks. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
The mother of detained Filipino activist Serena May Nacino appeals for financial help to bring her daughter home. On Monday, a Manila court allowed Nacino to post bail at 420,000 pesos for the illegal possession of firearms and explosive cases she is facing. But her mother says she cannot afford the bail.
Saan naman ho kami kukuha ng ganong kalaking halaga? Mahirap lang ang buhay ho namin. Sapat lang kumain kami tatlong beses ang araw. Parang hindi ko yata kakayanin yun. Siguro kahit ikamatay ko yun, hindi ko makakayang bayaran yun.
For the group Kapatid, a support network for relatives of political detainees, the excessive bail bond in exchange for freedom is in itself another injustice. Former Supreme Court spokesperson and criminal law professor Theodore Te, meanwhile, says it's time for bail reform. He says the bail bond guide of executive issuance should only be a guide for the judiciary, adding setting of bail must be based on both law and equity.